morning, everybody. The people you see up here to my right and to my left are students who went on these mission trips that Donnie mentioned earlier. And real quick, will you please just introduce yourself, your name, and where you went?
Hi, I'm Jacqueline. I am a freshman here, and I went to Beach Region, South Padre Island.
Hi, I'm Dawson, and I went to Fort Worth.
Hi, I'm Michael, and I
went to Padre Island. Hello, I'm Sam, and I went to Fort Worth as well.
Awesome. Well, so Jacqueline, we're going to start with you. You went to South Padre Island for Beach Reach. Will you tell us what you did there?
So what we did in South Padre is we would go out every night, whether we started at 8 a.m. or we started around 11 or we started around 8 p.m. We go out till 3 a.m. Picking up spring breakers and giving them free rides. We also would serve free unlimited breakfast and pancakes to anyone who wanted it. And we also gave out these hotline cards on the streets and around the beach just to anyone so they can call us and they have all of our information.
Dawson, will you tell us about what you did in Fort Worth?
Yeah, so we were a part of what's called Launch Crew, so we were kind of like the leaders of the week. And youth groups came in, and so we helped lead the youth groups as they went and served at various mission spots, but more specifically with apartment complexes that have refugees. So we did like VBS with the kids and stuff like that. So.
Awesome, thank you all. Guys, I'm gonna ask you a question about the overall purpose of your trips that you went on. So Michael, you went to Beach Reach as well, so will you tell us what the overall purpose of Beach Reach was?
So the overall purpose was not just venerating others about Jesus and all that he did for us, just like show them the love of Christ he did for us.
Awesome, absolutely, thank you. Sam?
So our purpose was really twofold. We were working with youth groups there, and so in a way we were discipling the youth, but we were also ministering to the kids in the apartment complexes, and so we were kind of showing the youth like how to reach out to the kids. So it was really cool in that way.
Awesome. So we want to take an opportunity now to hear more than just what we did, but really the things that happened. And so everybody's going to get an opportunity to share about something that God did, or one story that demonstrate what God did on your trip. So Jacqueline, we're going to start with you. What's one story that demonstrates what God did at Beach Reach this past week?
Okay, so one night I was in a van with JR, and we were doing a fishing where we would just go pick up whoever needed a ride. We would just ask them. We picked up two guys. Their name was Brandon and Ian. And when they got in our van, they were just a little intoxicated. Just a little. But they were still like very open with us, and it was very nice to be able to talk to them. But as the van ride went, we were going around taking them to Whataburger at I think around 2 a.m. And they were just overall like very open with themselves, and we got to a gospel conversation, and they both were talking about how they wanted to get back into Christ, but they didn't know how or where to start. And as that night went on, we had about a 30-minute extra conversation in front of Whataburger, and before they got out, I prayed for them, but they didn't really leave off on a good note. As we're driving back to the hotel, I had told JR, I said, JR, can we turn around? God's laying something on my heart to go talk to these guys. It was like something is speaking to me and I need to go finish this conversation. So we went to Whataburger, stayed there for about another hour, just talking to them and giving them, you know, churches around their area, and we're talking about, you know, what they need to do, and we had prayed for them. And then later that night in the van ride on the way back to where they were going, they had recommitted their lives, both of them, and I'm still in contact with them today, and they are both now going on a mission very soon. So God did very good work there.
So for me, this trip was kind of the first mission trip that I'd been on in probably about 3 years, just with COVID and just life. And so I was really excited to go, but also nervous. And so one of the things that I was very intentional about doing was stopping, just taking moments to pause and to take a step back and to just like see what God was doing in front of me. And so, like, I would do that, and I loved seeing the youth students just loving on refugees that have came from situations that we can't even imagine. And so I loved just being able to experience, like, God through them. But one experience that I had more specifically was with two little girls, and I never got where they were actually from because they spoke very little English. But they were in third grade, or I asked what grade they were in, and they said three. So we're assuming third grade. And one of the days, I just started drawing with chalk while we were hanging out with them. And one of the girls who spoke better English, she was asking me all these questions, and I had drew out the three circles. And so I was explaining that to her. But I was, you know, kind of when I left, I was like, okay, God, like, I pray that that planted a seed, but I also know that she really didn't understand what I was saying. So God, just, like, I hand this little girl over to you, like, just move in her life. And the next day, like, I just prayed. I was like, God, give me opportunity to, like, share with her again just the love of you. Like, not saying, like, this great conversion story, God, but just let her see you through me. And she kept asking questions. Like, as soon as I got there, she started asking me more questions of, like, what does this mean? How does God know me like that? How does he love me like that? And so we just got to have that conversation. And, you know, she didn't be like, oh, I want to follow Jesus. Like, there wasn't this crazy big story, but just watching God work through that and allowing him to use me in that, it was just so neat to see from one day to the next of her just asking more questions. And, like, I left in tears. And she asked me, she was like, why are you crying? And I was like, because I just love you so much, and I just want Jesus, like, to infiltrate your life. And so that was my, just God showing up. And
yeah. I'm going to be honest. I was really discouraged, like, the first day, because I was presenting someone the gospel. And then while I was presenting them, they interrupted me and said that it was basically, like, worthless. And I feel, like, so hurt in that moment. I feel like I wasn't there for a reason. But then I had to talk with my girlfriend and JR, and they told me that I was faithful. And, like, no matter what I did, I still planned that scene to them. I also helped with the recommitment with Brendan and Ian. But I also, 2 days later, I led someone to Christ for the first time. And honestly, that felt, like, so amazing. I feel like I can, like, do anything with Christ who strengthens me. I feel like I want to keep on doing that. Like, I don't want to stop at Beach Roots. I want to keep on going.
Yeah, so for me, I think the most impactful conversation I had was with one of the boys at the apartments. He was probably about 12 or 13. His name was Mashawn. And I just saw him sitting by himself on top of an AC unit, so I just went over there and sat on top of the other AC unit next to him. And we just started talking, and I don't know, he opened up. He was like, he was living with his mom and two brothers, and I could just see a sense of, like, hopelessness in him. He seemed very depressed. And I just asked him, you know, what he was interested in, what he liked to do. And he's like, well, I like to play sports. I like to play football, and I want to go to the NFL. And eventually get a home for my family. And, like, I don't know, that just kind of, like, like, hit me. Because when I was his age, you know, I had a similar dream. I wanted to go play in the NFL, but I didn't want to do it for my family. I wanted to do it for myself. Like, and it just, I don't know, it touched my heart because I could see, like, how he wanted to change and how he wanted to have hope. But the situation he was in was kind of hopeless. And I shared with him a little bit of my testimony, and I shared with him about Christ, and he was like, yeah, I'm just not sure, you know. And I was like, bro, that's fine. Like, it's okay to not know. But what I do want you to know is that God will take care of you. He'll take care of your family. Like, you don't have to carry that burden. And in leaving, it was hard because that was the last day, and so I didn't see him again. And I probably never will. I'll probably never see a lot of the people I saw there. And that, in a way, that inspired me because I was like, I've been thinking about doing missions long-term, and I was like, should I do it or should I not? And I think the one thing I took away is, like, yes, like, there are people there that I need to reach out to and that I need to go and help. There's millions of Michonne's all over the world, and it's up to us to go and to make a difference in their lives. So, yeah.
Well, thank you. Yeah. I want to thank each and every one of you for sharing your story. You know, the Bible tells us that we as followers of Jesus, because we have been saved by God through his love, through his son, Jesus Christ, that we who have received his love have the opportunity to share his love. And the Bible tells us that we as followers of Jesus, that we have the opportunity to make an appeal to the world. And that is God making his appeal through us to the world. That as we have been changed, so can God change anybody who would call upon his name. And truthfully, when you go out to be a witness to other people, you're going to face people who don't share the same value for what you value. Sometimes they go to the extent where they mock that. Michael even talked about discouragement. And the truth is that when you make yourself vulnerable, sometimes that comes with a little bit of a social cost. But the thing that God's word tells us is that when we are faithful to serve him, and when we allow him to make his appeal through us to others, and we put ourselves out there, out on the line, that not only are we offering to others the opportunity to know him, to know his love, and to grow in faith, but those who serve also grow. And so I want to ask each and every one of you to please share, how has this experience, going to Beach Reach or going to Fort Worth, how has this experience helped you to grow?
So, starting off, I'm going to be completely honest with all y'all. That was my past. It was like looking in a mirror at all these spring breakers. It's part of my testimony, and so being able to go out and share with them, you know, how God has impacted me in getting out through, getting me out of that hard time going out and partying and all that. And honestly, just down there and facing these spring breakers, spiritual warfare is real. And down there, it's something else that I thought I would never feel, and it took a toll on me to better myself, to take my past and really kick it like out of my life, to completely focus myself on God, because he is more powerful than we all think. And it's amazing. Like, I don't know how I would be today if I didn't have him in that close relationship with him, because honestly, it is just, it's helped me through a lot, and it's growing me to this day, and it grew me even after Beach Reach.
So I love going and serving in other places, because it kind of takes you out of your routine and forces you into a whole lot of like uncomfortable situations, and you have no control over them. And so you're very aware of what's happening. And through that, this last week, God really opened my eyes to the fact that, like, whenever I was praying just to pray. I wasn't praying expecting God to answer those prayers. And so this last week, whenever I would be like, God, like, use this student to speak to these kids, or give me an opportunity to speak to Raziki, he answered those prayers. And I was very aware of that, because I was looking for him to answer that prayer. So whenever I was like, God, give me a chance to share with her again, like, I was very, I guess, hyper aware almost of looking for that opportunity and seeking out God to answer that prayer. And so for me this week, like, just what I'm taking out of it and what I've grown, I guess, in is just when I pray, like, pray with expectation, and don't just pray and then be like, okay, I prayed, whatever. Like, no, like, I'm going to pray, and then as I go out, I'm going to be watching for God to answer that prayer, whatever it looks like, whether it's a job or a situation or a friendship or, you know, just God, get me through today, like, help me make it to the end of today, or to get that assignment done, like, and just watch for God to answer that prayer.
I grew into my faith, honestly. Like, after that first successful gospel conversation, I didn't want to stop there. And after each time, I became more in open with them and, like, told them what I've been through and how, like, God helped me through that. Like, I don't want to stop telling people about Jesus now. Like, that was Beach Reach, but like the mission doesn't stop there. It's everywhere we go.
So for me, I guess it ties in with that conversation I had with Michonne, because I had been thinking about doing like longer term missions before this trip, and I was having second thoughts about it before the trip. But after this trip, it showed me that, yeah, like there's, well, it's hard because I saw that in that short time, there was not a lot I could do. Like I talked to these kids and I got to know them for about 3 or 4 days and then we left. And it kind of broke my heart because I saw the desperation and I realized like in the amount of time I had given, I couldn't make that much of a difference. Like I could make a difference, a big difference, but to really make an impact, it would take time. And that spoke to me in that moment, and I realized like that's a confirmation of where God's calling me to, because to really have an impact somewhere, you have to devote time to it. And so that's how it challenged me. And yeah, just seeing that here was a kid who was 12 or 13 years old, and his motivation or what he was wanting to do was for other people. Like he wasn't thinking of himself. And to me, it's just that mindset of like, what can I do for others instead of what can I do for myself? And that's what I want to take with me from the trip.
That's awesome. Thank you guys for sharing about that. So before I pray for us to be dismissed here in a moment, I do want to give a word of encouragement to all of you and to anybody who will be watching at some point, that living a life of sacrifice and of service to others, like there's really no greater way to live your life than to live it for others. If I can, I'm going to tell a quick story because I led the team to Beach Reach, and we went down to the beach. And I mean, when we got down there, you know, there were thousands of people on the beach. And so I was walking around, and one of the things that I do and I share with others is like, you know, when I'm going out to share my faith with somebody else, that can be hard, you know, to go up to somebody who's having a conversation already and you kind of jump in, you're like, hey, how's it going? And then all of a sudden you're like, hey, what do you believe about God? And people are like, okay. And so I'm walking around the beach and I'm praying and I'm like, Lord, will you just make it obvious to me who it is that might want to talk with me about this? And as I started walking, I saw this guy who was sitting down on the beach, and he goes, hey, brother, what's up? I didn't know the guy at all. And I'm like, you, let's talk, you know? And so we talked for about 30 minutes. And we talked about faith. We talked about his family. We talked about his hopes for his family and his kids. And one of the things that he kept saying to me is that he thinks that everything or anything that is valuable that we know about, that's valuable for teaching, for life, for growth, that it should be shared freely. And I'm sitting there thinking, brother, you're preaching, right? You're preaching, man. And so I shared with him, I was like, well, you know, the truth is that God's word tells us that the free gift of eternal life comes through Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and believing in him and trusting in him. And I was thankful because he was kind enough and receptive enough to have a conversation with me about that. And so as I talk about that, or the reason I share that story is, in my form of encouragement for all of you, is this, that wherever you may be in your faith, the idea of sharing your faith can be difficult, can be hard, can be scary. But I want you to know that we here at Wayland, Donnie, myself, we here at Wayland want to see you have opportunities to where you can share your faith, the things you live for, the reason you believe in God. Because one of the most powerful things we have is our story. Would y'all say so? Like, our stories are one of the most powerful things that we carry with us. And so if you are in a place right now in your faith where you feel that conviction and you feel that stirring to want to share your faith, just know that we will walk with you through that. And we're not going to throw you straight into the fire, but we will walk with you through it and help you to get to the next stage and to the next step and to the point where you feel comfortable going to share your faith here on our campus. And so if you have any questions about what it was like to go on one of these mission trips, I know that these four and the others who went on those trips would love to share with you more about their experiences than what we can share now in this time. But also, if you want to know more about faith, if you want to know more about the Bible or anything like that, what it looks like to be a faithful witness to God in the world, We're here to talk with you through that. And another thing, too, is if you feel ready to go out on, we say mission, but to be a faithful witness on a trip around the world, if you're ready for something like that, we have mission trips that we have throughout the year that we would love to give you the opportunity to explore and to consider and pray over and possibly go on. So I just want you to know that we are here for you in those ways. But other than that, if you guys are willing to pray with me, I'll pray, and then you get to get out of here. All right. So let's pray. Father, I want to thank you for this day and everything that you have done today, but also everything you've done in our lives leading up to this point. Because God, if we look back at our lives, I believe that we can't help but see your faithfulness, your love, your compassion, and your kindness, and all these things, all of who you are playing out in our lives. And God, I want to thank you for the people who served this past week, gave up their spring break to go and be faithful witnesses wherever they were, to really pour themselves out so that others may benefit. God, I also want to thank you for every single person who's out here right now sitting down, listening to us, giving us a kind ear to hear, but also those who will be watching that. God, I pray for them that wherever they are in their faith, wherever they are in their life, that, Father, ultimately, more than anything, they will come to know your love through your Son, Jesus, that you died for us, that we could live new lives, be forgiven and freed from sin. God, I pray that you will help them to flourish. And Father, if I'm just being real, I know that we only have a few more weeks in the semester, and many of them are tired. So God, I pray that you bring them rest, that you would renew their spirit, restore them. And Father, as we move forward, I pray that in all things we glorify you. So Lord, without saying much more, I just want to say thank you. And we pray thanking you for all these things in Jesus' most holy name. Amen. Amen. Hey, you guys are dismissed. Have a great day. Thanks for coming.